Sissy, you're a real cactus blossom. Beauty that takes the best. Looks like we got company, Miss Carmelita, and not the friendly kind. I'll keep the raft still, and you blast those dead jackalopes!
Why don't you guards just get out of my way?
We got attackers to the left! I told you they were called
cantaloupes. Maybe you should just focus on the mission, Tennessee. This boat is steady, Tennessee!
All you can do is complain?
You better use your pistol on that river gate or we're going swimming! Now that's what I call straight shooting!
Is this a combustible engine or is this a paddle engine?
Whoa! Those steers up there mean business!
I don't know what's happening.
Huh, that switch looks kinda important.
Not like we just used one of them. Poor Tennessee Kid Cooper. What is this thing? Am I sniping at them from here? Thank you, God.
Get your boots on, gang. Tennessee's on the way.
Tennessee, this way.
Okay. Where did you come from? When could you fire that so quickly?
You go on. I'll stay here and cover you.
Okay.
It's
lit! What?
the wrong outlaw. Tennessee, just one more lock.
All right, keep those 30 birds in the cage. We're going to give Lou Paradox an early Christmas present.
I hope you boys got a backup plan. Looks like some dopes are still looking for a fight.
I didn't.
Carmelita, are you all right?
I am. No thanks to you. I should leave you in that cage after what you pulled, Sly Cooper.
I know. Look, I can explain everything.
Well, if it wasn't for this handsome and charming gentleman, I wouldn't even be here.
Aw, shucks.
Handsome and charming? Really? Look, Carmelita, I know...
Save it, Sly. All I want to know right now is how I get back to Paris.
Actually, Carmelita, I was more curious how you got here in the first place.
But guys, where's the van?
We'll have to track it down later, Murray. Now, what were you saying, Carmelita?
It's a long story, Bentley. Let's get moving and I'll tell you.
Just say it now! Don't spin.
When I saw that arrogant little, that no good lying, I should have tied his mangy tail around his neck. I should have blasted that smug look right off his face. I should probably just finish my story. After the Cooper gang escaped at the museum, I decided to follow my nose and take a look around. I'd been investigating the trading of stolen antiquities on the black market, but I'd never guessed that two-faced ringtail was involved. Then as I turned a corner, I was stunned to see a huge stash of stolen treasure right there in the museum. And even more shocking, Cyril Le Paradox himself unloading them. I couldn't believe it. The billionaire art collector and museum patron was behind this? I was so surprised that by the time I reacted, his goons already had me covered. Then that slimy sawed-off runt had me thrown into some vile machine. And the next thing I knew, I was playing cowboys and criminals. The Old West? Time travel? It was completely loco. Sure, Le Paradox had done some time in his youth, but he'd been squeaky clean ever since. And Interpol had never considered him a suspect. There were rumors about the source of his wealth, but nothing had ever been proven. Now I knew I'd solved that mystery. And of course Cooper and his little friends were involved somehow. Why was I not surprised? The flea bag tried to feed me some story about having to rob the museum to save the future. But I was done listening to that liar. I needed to get back to Paris. But that toad toothpick had stolen Murray's van, and Bentley's time machine along with it. I finally cracked the case, and now I was stuck in this lousy dust bowl with the Cooper gang. I don't know what made me angrier. Not being able to bust the lowlife skunk, or being trapped here with that lying ringtail. Ooh! The only bearable thing about this whole mess was that at least Cooper's ancestor was a gentleman.
Something needs to be done about those Cooper characters. I don't like them skulking around my town or my mine. They better not care about nothing going wrong with the plan. Better not. Oh, boy, you got a funny look. Got something to say, huh? Something happened up at the mine? No? Good, because our old referee's partner, he don't take kindly to mistakes. And right now, we still need his help! Would it hurt one of you to break out the dust clock once in a while, huh? Take a gander at this office. He's disgraced. It's so dusty, I can barely
as the broccoli again. Just pull up more broccoli, man. Yep. I don't know what's happening. This level, it's definitely, yeah. Why are you playing as Marie right now? I don't really know.
In Toothpick's office, we have a pretty clear idea of what's going on. Toothpick plans on moving the stolen gold out of the mine using his special train. Unfortunately, that train is now also being turbocharged by our van. And need I mention that we're stranded in time unless we recover it? Well, anyway, it's useless to go after the train in the mine. Toothpick will have stepped up security since our escape, and the place will be crawling with guards. We're going to have to hit
Spider's
that train
guards.
While it's rolling. But first, we're going to have to catch it. And we'll do that by diverting its route. After surveying the rail system, I've determined there are three key track switches we will need to throw. And Toothpick has entrusted the keys to three of his toughest henchmen. Wildman Wiesner, Frenchie Lestache, and Red Eye Robles. Furthermore, these guys keep the keys around at all times. The good news is that during the Toothpick Appreciation Festival, there are a number of contests, and all of them will be competing. Murray, I took the liberty of entering you in the Bare Knuckle Brawl Contest. Wildman is the defending champion, and he's sure to have the key on his person. Sly, I hope you're feeling fast because you're going to be competing in the crookedest race in the West, the Toothpick 500. Frenchie happens to be the defending champ, so it's a sure bet it's his time that you'll have to beat. Carmelita, you'll be up against Red Eye in the shooting contest. As the defending champ, he keeps the trophy close by with the third key inside.
Why
now
Carmelita?
Let's get
Why
going.
Not?
We don't have any time to waste.
Why not Tennessee Kid Cooper for the shooting contest? What the fuck? Stupid ass dog.
Alright, listen up, you flea bags. This here's the annual Toothpick Brawl-a-thon. Ain't no rules excepting if you want a shot at the champ. You gotta fight your way through the ranks first. Looks like we got ourselves a sucker. Yeah, I mean challenger. So let's get on with it. Fighting out of the pink corner from parts unknown. Way more than he should. The challenger, Murray. Let's hope he fights better than last year's contestant. May he rest in peace. And in this corner, needing no real introduction, weighing in a little more every minute, your howling horn, the coyote!
Put the broccoli down.
Oh!
three?
Nice.
Move! Fuck! Bite his ear. Yeah, I... How am I supposed to...
Because, you know...
Don't say it!
That's how I roll. I feel like I'm in the circus.
Why you gotta be like that, man?
Time to show these folks some real speed.
I'm pretty sure I...
Hurry up! The clock is ticking!
I'm pretty sure I've actually run faster.
My time is running out!
Oh. My legs feel like spaghetti. Why do I feel like I'm back in prison?
You better what? Get on the ball, Fly.
Come on, man!
Just keep the ball spinning, Sly. Better keep an eye out for that jackal.
You can do this, pal!
What is the point of the checkpoints then? Oh my god.
I feel like I'm in the circus.
No time for jokes, Fly. You better get moving.
This definitely reminds me why I prefer picking pockets.
That's it, Fly. Keep pushing. Come on, Fly. Get your back into it.
Look, even my tail is tired. This is the craziest race I've ever seen.
Hurry up! The clock is ticking!
I didn't mean to do that.
Oh, my legs feel like spaghetti.
My time is running out!
Time to show these folks some real speed.
You better get on the ball, Fly.
Shut your goddamn mouth.
We're in a time crunch here, Fly.
Why do I feel like I'm back in prison?
Come on, you've almost got this race won.
Just keep the ball spinning, Sly.
Concentrate, it's just a little further.
Okay.
Keys,
Fly.
Now scram!
Oh, now that's some fine shooting right there. Well, that's it, folks. Looks like this year's champion is gonna be... Wait! Wait on everything, we got ourselves a latecomer. Let's see what this pretty little lady has got.
Well, what have we here? Little lady, I know you can't be here to shoot, because there ain't even no man around these parts can stand up to me.
Why can't I just
see what
shoot
you mean.
Him right
I
now?
Can barely stand you myself.
But if you're scared of losing, I understand.
Get your goddamn tits in order.
Well, I just won the competition, what? So you're too late. But I'll tell you what, I'll make you a deal. You just go right ahead, sweet thing. If you can beat my score, you get this here trophy.
Gore, do you think but you can make you better lose, coyotes?
You gotta give me a kiss. What do you say?
Aye. This guy's breath smells like fermented gym socks.
Carmelita, we don't have a choice.
All right, I'll take your wager. But you better get ready to hand over that trophy.
And you better get ready for some serious lip wrestling.
Is that what they call it these days? What am I supposed to be shooting at?
To wipe the grin off this clown's face. Don't call me Top Shot at Interpol for nothing. The only thing this creep will be kissing is that trophy. Goodbye. This guy's in for an unpleasant surprise.
Hello?
Just have to keep my focus. It actually helps if I picture Sly's face on the target.
How is this missing? Can I actually get a crosshair and not a giant box?
I could do this left-handed. Show you the big jerk how to shoot. Don't call me Top.
What the? Oh, this ain't happening. It's like some kind of magic trick.
The only thing disappearing is your trophy, Red Eye.
Way to go, Carmelita! Now grab that key!
She's not even wearing high heels, and yet I gave her the high heel sound for the... What? Sad coyote. I mean, I can make a better coyote Sona. I just gotta put a rainbow on him and like I need to make him like half demon and give him wings and give him a halo because he's also half angel and
And another thing. No more whistling. I don't want to hear no guards whistling for no reason, no how, no way.
Well, I die.
I don't care if it's for a pretty girl on a sunny day in springtime. La 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 la. Don't want to hear it. Is that clear? Why? Because it aggravates my ear holes. It gives me headache to beat the band.
I know too much.
I try using them.
You obviously haven't seen my pony Sona, what's his name? Darkhoof? Darkhoof? Dark? Was it Darkhoof? I think it was Darkhoof. I think that's what his name was. Darkhoof. Was his name Darkhoof? Darkhooves. No, Darth Cummings was my roleplay name. On the Star Wars Arcade server. Stop! 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 Oh, God damn it. Didn't I get like a sprint or something? Sprint power? Whatever. Twinkie Ho 60. I am holding my own. I don't feel like I'm going fast enough. God, am I gonna make it in time? I really don't feel like I'm moving faster, but alright. Did that chicken just survive the train? I guess I am moving faster since I'm closer to the train. I wish there was a visual cue that I was moving faster.
Okay, eyes front, everyone!
What?
The clock is ticking on this one, so we don't have time to monkey around! Toothpick's gold train is already rolling, and with the incorporation of our van, it's virtually impossible to stop. Thankfully, Tennessee was able to divert the train's route, which gives us the chance we need to catch it. First, Murray, you're going to get the van back. It's positioned near the rear of the train, acting not unlike a booster rocket. It's going to take your considerable fighting skills just to reach it. The catch is that it's being secured with a set of special magnetic locks, which can only be broken by someone of your immense strength. Once the van is free, you'll be able to catch the train and pick each of us up as we complete our tasks. Carmelita, you and I will tackle the next set of cars. I need you to use your peerless marksmanship and cover me while we make our way forward. It won't be easy. The train is crawling with guards, and they'll be gunning for both of us. Our goal is to reach a computer terminal near the middle of the train, where I'm going to do a little hacking. As we already know, Toothpick cannot stand high-pitched frequencies, particularly whistles. So I'll reroute the power and control of the steam whistles on the train engine. Something tells me this will come in handy when we finally reach him. Sly and Tennessee, you're up next. To ensure we stop Toothpick, we'll need to cover all possible escape routes. So Sly, you'll take the roof of the train. Tennessee, you'll move through the cars, where we should be able to reclaim your gold along the way. But your gunslinging will definitely be put to the test. You both should reach the engine around the same time, where you can take Toothpick down. The rest of us will catch up with you in the van. One last thing. Don't forget we're a team, and that's the only way we're going to be able to pull this off. Everyone needs to execute their part of the plan perfectly if we're going to get the van, steal the gold, and stop Toothpick. Now let's move out!
Alright, what are we doing? Cool boys aren't partial to peer pressure. What the duck is happening here? Oh, hello. That was unsafe. What if we blow up the van?
Take it easy, Murray!
turned up.
Outstanding, Murray! The man is ours!
The Murray is back in the driver's seat!
Okay, Carmelita, we need to get to that terminal at the forward car. I just hope you brought plenty of ammunition. You really should think of it as correcting history.
Ha! You call yourselves guards?
Blast up, Carmelita! Okay, Carmelita, we need to get to that terminal at the forward car. I just hope you brought plenty of ammunition. You really should think of it as correcting history. Outstanding, Carmelita! Shooting in my hiding, we make a great team. Now to jack that terminal. All right, time for a hack attack. Yes, I'll have those whistles rigged in a jiffy.
She died. Yeah, she's dead, dude. Duck, man.
Just crashed. What a hide! No!
Yeah, we did it. I'm in. We did it. I'm in. Ease peas, lemon squeeze.
Fly the whistles are the key!
It's my ear holes! I think I have far to go!
Yes!
Okay, Bentley. Glad I could help out.
And yet another system falls before my skill. Go get him, boys!
About time! My trigger finger is twitching!
Alright, so how are we gonna lose, Kid Cooper's cane? Because we all know what's going to happen.
Time to pay old Toothpick back for stealing the gold I could have took.
I'm going to get around the bus, dude.
Open. Put this bus to back my lollipop, because I can't find them. You got any idea how stressful that is? It's making me itch. I can't even scratch because it's under my armor. Somebody better find those lollipops and get them to me fast! I mean pronto! Because I'm not happy! And when I'm not happy, you're not happy! Understand? Everybody keep an eye out for those blasted Coopers! And when I say blasted,
I might have to retire after this one!
Probably heard the saying!
Purchase the paraglider? What was the point of getting the unlockable then?
Faster, Murray!
You got it, chum!
Keep her steady!
I thought it meant I have to buy the skin for the...
Bullseye! Okay. Great job, Tennessee! We'll keep this safe for now.
Do you know how heavy gold bars are?
Great! Keep moving forward, Tennessee!
I thought it meant that I have to buy the monkey version off of Steam for $5 because it's a skin.
This heist is gonna be my biggest yet! I'm gonna wipe that smirk right off Toothpick's face!
Now hear this! We got the intruders! Unacceptable! When you catch them, and you ever catch them, throw them off the train immediately! Whoa, no, wait, first, shoot them, then throw them off the train! Oh, wait, even better! Blow them up, shoot them, then throw them!
This here robber is gonna be one for the record books.
I haven't tried shooting the cameras, but.
Oh.
But. It just feels like I shouldn't be able to shoot the cameras. I feel like that would be too simple.
I know that some of you guards are probably wondering why you're doing this. You're thinking, what am I getting out of? Well, I wanted to let you all know.
Faster, Murray!
You got it, chum!
Keep her steady!
Where are they putting all this gold?
Come to daddy! Okay, Tennessee, we'll grab the rest once we stop the train!
That's not how it works.
Yes, you're almost there!
Time to pay old Toothpick back for stealing the gold I should have took. I'm gonna wipe that smirk right off Toothpick's face.
In the van's gold hole.
Why don't you bring your little runt self down here and take your whooping like a man, Sheriff?
What is that?
Blast you! Kid Cooper! I'm gonna lock you in the deepest, darkest hole, and I'm going to throw away the key!
Give it up, Toothpick! The fat lady is sung and you are done!
Oh, am I?
My gun!
No! Thanks, kid! Lou Paradox sends his regards! Adios, Idiot!
Relax, pal. I'll take care of this.
It's all over, Cooper!
Break out the Tailbird costume, Fly! Watch those lasers, Fly!
Why does everyone use lasers? Come on, Toothpick! I'm right here!
Did you get the tires yet?
Man, this guy is windmill.
Guys, how do you think it's those speed whistles going?
Well,
try hitting
guess I couldn't
bells.
Expect him to fight fair.
Don't speed chum! Oh, that hurts my ears! Who turned on that blasted whistle?
Watch out, Fly! He's trying to smash you!
I don't think, Hogwarts do this in real life.
Fly, watch out for those whirlwinds!
I should dodge these whirlwinds.
No! I will get hit by them! Instead, that is what I will- Ah! It's one big one!
He's shot, Fly!
Wow! You short-cutting, beef-handed!
But him being in the fire isn't doing enough damage already? Yeah. He should be dead! I know it's an armadillo, not a top part. It's a joke.
Did you forget your glasses? Can't stay in one place. Gotta keep moving.
Yeah, I was trying to, but you kept.
Talk less and aim more.
Stop fucking missing, you! Same animation. Why not just skip that and just have all right, the thingies.
No way to jump these twisters. I'll have to avoid them.
How the fuck are these? They're homing in on me.
Fly, he's dizzy!
Why, you mangy! Slow down, varmint scum! Let's see how you like my bang bang move dynamite!
It's too bad you can't shoot as well as you talk.
Stand up, Fly!
Let him squash me.
Just see his belt buckle has the what's a jig on it?
Try jumping those small whirlwinds.
No way to jump these twisters. We'll have to avoid them.
I'm sensing a discrepancy in the force. Motherfucker!
Just took care of that, Bentley.
No, why? The train! It's headed for a broken bridge!
I'm guessing that wasn't part of the plan?
Why, you have to get off that train! Jump to the van!
What about Tennessee? That wasn't even necessary. I could have made that jump. Without
Murray, the hit the brakes!
Why am I?
They're not working! And I can't shut down the rockets!
What? You idiots! You called this a plan? I knew this was a bad idea. I knew I should have had you send me back to Paris. Oh, I can't believe it's going to end like this.
What in tarnation are they doing? And I was just wondering where that Golden got to. Bentley!
Sorry, Murray. This has to work.
Hey, that's my necklace.
Here goes nothing.
As the van hurtled into the ravine, it felt like we were in slow motion. The thought that our adventures were over flashed through my mind as I braced for the crash. Then, in desperation, Bentley grabbed the closest thing at hand, Murray's Australian fossil necklace, and used it in the time machine. He saved our lives. But now, we had no idea where we were headed. We held on as the van was sucked through the wormhole, tumbling around like a cork in the ocean. Who knew where we'd land? And more importantly, when? Things weren't going very well. We'd landed somewhere, from the looks of it, prehistoric. I was slightly concerned when Bentley broke out the dinosaur repellent, but that was the least of my worries. The crash landing had damaged the van, so the time machine wasn't working properly. Not only was traveling back to Paris impossible, but we couldn't even raise Dimitri on the transceiver. Also, we still had no idea how the Paradox had managed to develop his own time machine. And that was a scary thought. Carmelita was still really hot about things. I just wanted a chance to explain, to tell her how sorry I was for getting her mixed up in all of this. Before we had a chance to talk, she stormed off in a rage. I tried going after her, but I figured that wasn't the best idea. Our conversation would have to wait, at least until she holstered that pistol. We decided the first order of business was figuring out where and when we were. And then, how we were going to repair the van. Otherwise, we'd have to get used to living in a cave, permanently.